Welcome back. This is the last topic in the numerical analysis part 2, which is called the modified Newton-Raphson method. It is a simple modification to the standard Newton method for approximating the root of multiple root function, same like x squared, x cubed, x to the 4. It's described, analyzed. For the same number of function and derivative evaluation, the modified method converges faster, is coming closer to the root faster. The expression xi plus 1 is equal to xi minus function of x value multiplied by the derivative value of xi divided by power 2 of the slope of xi minus f of xi multiplied by f double dash of xi, which is new item f double dash. For the example number 7, let function of x equal to the e of x minus 3x squared to an accuracy of 3 digits. Root is between 0.5 and 1. In order to utilize this general expression, we need the function value f of x as well as function derivative f dash and new item, which is f double dash. Starting, f of x is e to the x minus 3x squared. The first derivative is e to the x minus 6x, and f double dash will be equal again e to the x minus 6. Starting from 0.5 as x naught, we plug in the expression x1. If we put I equal to 0, our x0 in this time will be 0.5 minus the function value of 0.5 multiplied by the derivative value of 0.5 divided by f double dash squared of 0.5 minus f of 5 multiplied by f double dash of 5. So our starting point x0, this is an Excel sheet for which we put the xi here, and there will be containing three items. The first one is the first column, f of x, f dash of x, f double dash of x. We plug in 0.5, we get the corresponding value of f of 0.5, and this is the slope value minus 1.351, and this is the double dash of x, which is minus 4.351. The value of x1, this new value, will be equal to this value minus numerator, this one multiplied by that one, divided by the numerator, is f dash of x squared minus f of x multiplied by f dash of x. We will get this value. Again, we substitute, we get these three figures, and so on, we get x2. We plug in, we get f of x, f dash of x, and f double dash of x, and so on until we fill this item. We are seeking for the value f of x equal to 0. We will find that this value will be 0.91 of x, which will lead to f of x equal to 0. This is a detailed evaluation, and the solution converges to x equal to 0.91. I will download this as PDF, the PowerPoint. Another example to show the difference between Newton methods and modified Newton-Raphson method will be as follows. Example number 8, let function of x equal to the x cubed minus 5x squared plus 7x minus 3 with the first choice of x naught equal to 0. We have a clear look, thorough look to this equation. We find that this equation is having three roots, which is x minus 1 multiplied by x minus 1 multiplied by x minus 3. This is equal to 0, which means that the first root is x equal to 1, and the second root is also x equal to 1. The third root is x equal to 3. In order to find if you can be able to find this value x equal to 1 and x equal to 3 by using both Newton and Newton modified by plugging the first value as x not equal to 0. In Newton we need function value of x and f dash of x, while in the Newton modified Raphson method we need three values. These values are f of x, f dash of x, and f double dash of x. F of x is this one, f dash of x is 3x squared minus 10x plus 7. F double dash would be the derivative of the first f of dash. I make Excel sheet for which I've started here putting 0 for both, and for the first Newton I get f of x and f dash of x value, which is minus 3, 7. And this is the new value, x1. Plug in, find f of x, f dash of x. It will lead me to another point, x2 equal to 0.685714. For f of x is near 0, we'll find that it is almost 0.977655, and this will be done until the x6. It means that we have done 6 iterations, while in the Newton modified methods, as compared to that original method, when it started by 0, I get minus 3, and f dash value is 7, f double dash is minus 10. By substituting, I get 1.105263. Again, we plug in and we get f of x, f dash of x, f double dash of x, and so on, until I get 1, which is coming our solution. This is the first root coming to 1, but if we have a look, then we will find out that this one, how many steps we make 3 iteration as compared to 6 iteration. For the other root, x equal to 4, we make substitution by first choice x equal to 4, which is in the next sheet. For x not equal to 4, try for the other root. This is again Newton, and this is Newton modified method. We make 5 iterations, and here we make 6 iterations, which will lead us to 3 here, and also starting from 4, it comes back to 3. I hope this example and the previous one were clear enough to find the difference between Newton and modified Newton method. Thanks a lot, and see you. Thanks to all for watching. I hope this was clear enough, and see you again.